In this video, we're going to cover the setup tasks that are done once when creating a new schedule. So in order to set up a new schedule, you go to the setup tab, and we can see there's various information that you'll need to update. There's step one, column dates, step two, and step three. So we're going to go through each one. First of all, there's a couple of columns in your schedule that you may customize. It defaults to phase and activity name. And if we go to the detail tab, you can see them that they're here. There are times when you will want to make these a different name. And if you do, you just come and change it here. The next is the starting end date. Now, FastGantt is organized into weeks. There's 36 weeks in total. And so you need to give it the end date of week one, so it knows where to start. I recommend making this a Friday, but you may make it any date you like. You may make it a Sunday or a Wednesday or whatever, but I usually go with Friday. We're gonna make it, in this case, November 9th. Current date or year, you can just enter the November 9th and it'll default to this year. So that makes November 9th the end of week one. You may then update and change the phase names. Now, these are the standards, so if you are good with these, you don't have to make any change. You'll notice that each phase begins with A-B-C- and so on. That does a couple of things. One is that it allows for sorting to take place. As you'll see in a future video, you do periodically sort your schedule, and this keeps it in order by phase. The second is that there is special formatting done so that every second phase is slightly grayed so that it makes for better readability. Again, only if you use this convention of ABCD with a dash. Finally, the third thing you can do is to update or tell FastGantt how to schedule. There's two options. One is you can schedule 7 days a week. That is, work will be scheduled Monday through Sunday, weekends and holidays included. And for some projects, you may want to do that. For other projects, you may want to have it working days only, which is Monday through Friday. So no work is scheduled on the weekends. And no work would be scheduled on any dates that you put in here. So for example, if the schedule includes New Year's, we would put, for example, January 1st, 2019, and then work would not be scheduled on New Year's Day because it is working days only. If it was 7 days a week, it would schedule work on New Year's Day because it's 7 days per week. So that's the end of the setup video.